All right, let's see if I can do something with this. See if I can figure out my camera. What did I do with my, there it is. Okay, so first time somebody gave me one of these, it's like, and it was boring. It wasn't interesting. It didn't feel interesting, which is the most important part for me, is how it feels to me. So basically, okay, we're talking about music. We're talking about four beats to the bar. And if you just play four beats, you go bop, 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 bop. It's redundant. Bop, 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 bop. Sounds like a metronome, right? So to add interest, you want to diversify it. So if you pull two different sounds out of it, one sound being, give it a light, smooth. And I know you may not have this shaker. It works the same way if we're... Works the same way with this guy. This is just a little louder and easier to demonstrate what I'm talking about. So holding it with your thumb facing you, you're like that, give it a little elbow action like that and a little soft shimmy like that. Give it kind of shook, 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 shook. The other motion would be more of a pendulum or metronome. Get a more staccato, a more percussive sound off the top. So if we alternate those two, so we get a shh, shh, punk, shh, punk, shh, punk, or whatever along those lines, depending on which one of those four beats you want to accent. I mean, if we're just going one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, but if we're doing a one and two and three and four, one, nice, one and two and three and four, one, 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 two, one, two, as I'm counting it off, you get a different sound out of it depending on which ones you're accenting. Regardless, the takeaway for all of this is using a couple of different motions to get a couple of different sounds out of it, whether it be little motions or hard percussive motions. Some of it is a back and forth. Some of it is a drop, depending on what kind of sound you're going for there. Let me give you a quick example of how this is going to play out against. We were talking about that Dierks Bentley song. Let's see here.
Yeah.
So you can see how pulling the two different sounds out of that, I can make different accents and make it sound more interesting. So that's something to play around with. And the reason that I'm kind of pushing you on the percussion toys is because, bearing in mind that you're playing rhythm guitar, its primary purpose is to keep rhythm. And when we're talking about the strumming patterns and that kind of stuff and making sure we've got the right thing going on there, if you look at that motion pattern like that, and then I take my guitar, watch my hand there, you can see that we're talking about the same motion, the same thing. So as we get that rhythm going on with your hand, and that's why, like I say, I'm encouraging you to play with it and have fun with it, because it is a lot of fun. You find all kinds of different patterns you can throw in there and mix in with the patterns of the song you're playing along with. Anyway, that's 5 minutes worth, kiddo, and hopefully it was worth your time. I love you. Talk to you later. Bye.